And it's the birth of a new club as we're underway in Draft Champions. Short kick here, fielded about the 17. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Seahawks are going to take a timeout here on defense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Here's the first carry for Le'Veon Bell, and he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down.
Frankly, Brandon, we're talking about things I'm not sure we ever thought we'd talk about in the NFL, and a lot of that is the speed at the linebacker position. A lot of these guys in college, they were safeties. They moved them up to outside linebacker to combat the spread offenses, and now we're seeing it in the NFL, those same guys using their speed to make plays in the backfield, similar to that one.
Now Wilson, looking deep downfield. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line. That could be a downside of putting together a team in Draft Champions Week 1. It's early. You might have some of these mistakes.
You're exactly right, because it does take time to build chemistry, trust, right, understanding where guys are going to be. And I think that's what led to the interception. They just don't know each other well enough yet. That should build up as the season goes on.
Here's the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And not much there. Maybe a yard up to the 24. A wall of Dolphins, and there are lots of them there to make the stop.
A one-yard gain could look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of one-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional one-yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
Now a second down throw for Mariota. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete. Chris Conley, the intended receiver, and it's third down. And defensively, it's a nickel formation here on third down and 9. Mariota to throw it. Flushed out right. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. Given 9 on the play, and that's going to bring up a fourth down. So in their own territory, but they only need a few inches, so they're going to opt to go for this thing. We'll see. Maybe a surprise pass, a run. What will they do? We're about to find out. Fourth down. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. And out come the Dolphins now. So they take a big, big chance here in their own territory, and you think the coach may have some questions to answer?
Yeah, and, you know, normally we focus on the media, right, the social media barrage that he's going to get for this one. How about on his own sideline and in his locker room?
Yeah.
Because I think the team's going to look at him like, coach, why would we go for it there? I mean, no confidence in the defense. You don't like the punter. I mean, what's going on here? You owe us some explanations.
Play clock down to 0. And this is not the way to start a drive. And now again, the play clock's going to run out on him. Gun. Here's Wilson. Complete to right. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. Give him 2 yards on that play, and it'll be a second and long. So a defensive brain lapse there and an encroachment penalty.
Sometimes when you don't watch the football and make sure that it's snapped, you're watching the offensive player, and they can influence you occasionally and look like they're getting ready to move, and the officials don't detect it.
So now 13 yards to go, second and 13 after the penalty marker thrown. On second down, here's Wilson. Goes underneath for Bell. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. It's a gain of 5. And that'll lead here to a third down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play. But if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
Well, good field position to start the drive, but under the gun now here on 3rd and 8. Play action. It's Wilson. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Kendall Wright, the intended target. And it's 4th down.
Putting pressure on the guy throwing the football is always good. But when you can couple that with contact on him that leads to an incompletion, as we just saw there, that's winning football.
And Succop will put this one right through. And the Dolphins will jump out to a 3-0 lead. So a good kick there, and they wrap up the drive by putting 3 on the board.
And you know, let's face it, you're not always going to come away with 6. Defense in the NFL are just too good. But you've got to come away with something. And there, they get 3.
This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And on that last drive, went for it on 4th, turned it over. But good job by their defense, though. They held him to 3, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on 4th down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it.
The Dolphins get there this time, and they bring him down. Jerry Hughes in there to get him for a loss of 5. Well, they were coming out of the 4-3 defensively. Pressure coming off that right side from the DM.
And that's the blind side of most quarterbacks. If you're right-handed, that's the side you don't see quite as well. And that's why you rely on your left tackle, maybe your highest-paid offensive lineman, to take care of you. In this situation, that didn't happen.
And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position, couldn't hold on, 3rd down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
3rd down, 15 yards still needed. Third and long here for Mariota, eluding the pressure right and unable to connect on the long pass. It falls down incomplete.
But no second guessing the call here. It was 3rd and long, so throwing the football was probably the smart play to try and pick it up. But they don't get it, and now the defense goes off the field feeling pretty good about themselves, gaining some momentum as they force them into a likely punting situation.
Mariota now. He's going to go deep for Conley. And this is incomplete. Boy, a real head scratcher there. And out possession's going to go over with a football at the 20-yard line. And the Dolphins getting set to go here. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
Second and 10 now, Wilson. And that is incomplete. The man with over 1,000 catches, Jason Witten, the intended receiver. And it'll bring up third down. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
And on the left side, he's got Witten. It's a 10-yard gain there, and it sets him up now first and goal. Try to get one more in here before the quarter breaks.
And in a lot of ways, that catch is expected. Red zone presence, and that one was realized there. You've got to find your tight end in that situation.
Down, Wilson. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Just looking at it from a defensive perspective, when you break the huddle in the red zone, tight end is one of the guys you've got a key on because quarterbacks want the ball in their hands fast in this position, and they want to get it to someone. And in this case, he had the play. They just didn't complete it.
On second down, it's Bell. Legs, and he's going to ball his way into the end zone for the Dolphins score. Le'Veon Bell, a 9-yard touchdown run. And the Dolphins are able to grow their lead. And they're able to run it in. It started with a battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how are we going to slow down this running game, because on that particular play, they had no answer.
The kicking team out for Miami as they will send this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
They go play action here on first down. Dancing to his left. And some room to roam now. It comes and he lost the football. Mariota had it jarred loose.
I don't know about you, but I could hear and feel the sigh of relief all the way up here in our booth.
That was palpable. The sideline, the friend there.
No doubt about it. Ball goes over the sideline, able to retain possession. No turnover. I know his coaches are screaming, just hang on to the ball, man.
First down, Mariota. Flush to his right. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
Everything about that play tells you about today's NFL offenses and what they're asking out of running backs. You can't just be a guy who can run the football. You have to be able to catch it as well. And he didn't get that done on that play.
Second down now after the incompletion. A second down throw here for Mariota. Buying time to his left. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Jerry Hughes in there to get him. His second sack now of the afternoon. Dolphins bring on an extra defensive back on third down. Mariota from the gun on third down. And he's got it. Got his man on the end route. Complete. It's a gain of 11, but they're still well short. It's fourth down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. That's their second, so they'll have one remaining here in this second quarter. We'll be right back. So now on fourth down, Mike McCarthy will turn to his field goal unit. Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. Going to throw right side here. Complete. And they're able to pick up the first and keep possession. A big play there on the fake field goal. And the decision to go for it pays off. They've got a first and goal. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Brief break in the action here. We're back to Lambeau following these words. From the gun, Mariota escaping the pressure right. And he will score. Touchdown, Seattle. Marvin Harrison from 6 yards away. And the Seahawks have made this a one-score game. As a Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he'll get into the end zone as the two-point conversion is successful. And that's something you almost never see nowadays. When you fake it, you're at the 15-yard line on a PAT as opposed to just going for it from the two.
I'm sorry. I know they got it, and congratulations to them, but it's just not a good play. I mean, the risk-reward is really off the charts. Not in your favor. Run your offense out there. Put it on the 2-yard line if you want to go for two. But I'll be darned. They ended up getting that one, didn't they?
And they're going to wind up with pretty good starting field position as they get it up past the 35. The Dolphins offense now heads back on the field. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. That's going to go as a loss of 6, and it'll set them back for second down. Now Wilson on second down. Completes it to Jason Witten. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays, and you don't get many opportunities to dial them up, and they just did, and they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
And with very little time left on the play clock, Pete Carroll's going to call timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. So on fourth down, here's Jake Shum to punt it away. And a nice job here on special teams. This will be down inside the 10 at the 8-yard line. Here come the Seahawks now, set to take over on offense. And that last drive was very, very balanced, pretty methodical. You think they go that route again?
I'm always of the school that until they stop me from doing something, I'm willing to continue. And I think that that's exactly what they'll look to do. But the beauty is the balance that they've created sets up opportunities for big plays. Looks like a run, turn into a play action, and throw one deep.
A first down throw for Mariota. And now he'll tuck it and run. And they'll get him down up past the 15, just shy of the 20. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Well, that was man coverage. So once he decides to run with the football, there's no one to account for him, and he turns it into a nice gain.
Mariota now to throw on first down. Steps away to his left. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. 15 yards there on the scramble and a first down. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. First and 10, here's Mariota, flushed out right. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 45. It's a gain of 14 there, and it's good enough for a Seattle first.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
Out to his left. And some room to maneuver. It comes, and he lost the football. Mariota had it jarred loose.
And a little bit of good fortune there. He wasn't able to get it back, but he did have a teammate on the spot able to retain possession for them.
So the offense has it first and 10. They'll come out in the pistol. Mariota now. He'll buy some time right. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. So the defense has put them in a tough spot. It's second and long. So we've reached halftime here, and it's the visiting Dolphins taking a lead to the locker room as we send you down to our EA Sports Studios in Orlando, where we find our man Larry Ridley with our halftime report. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. And Seattle now ready to march out of the field. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess that in the locker room, they talked about cleaning up some of the errors. But overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up. And we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. They get 25 yards out of that one. And that'll be good for a Seattle first down. Mariota on first down. They'll roll him out right. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. It's an 8-yard pickup, and it'll make it a second down. Mariota now on second down. Oh, he tried to pitch it and the ball's loose. And his guys are going to take over at their own 48-yard line. A look at the offense now here coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they hit.
And he's got it inside the 10. And he is down deep into Seattle territory. It's a big play there for Miami. 47 yards. Throwing is Wilson. Goes underneath for Bell. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. It'll be a pickup of just 2, and that'll bring up a 2nd and goal. They'll try and run it in with Bell. And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a 3rd down. On 3rd and goal, Wilson. That's caught at the 2. Can this defense hold him out? Here we go now, 4th and goal from the 2.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. And they're not going to get this one off in time. It'll be a delay.